Now, feeding your tiger salamander is very easy. I recommend using your trusty forceps right here. It's just easier to use it instead of trying to feed them with your fingers. These guys have teeth, but they're not sharp enough to damage your skin. Their jaw pressure isn't even enough to hurt you. It does kind of feel like sandpaper rubbing on your finger. But again, use forceps. It's just a lot easier to do. Grab the food item, in this case, a small cockroach. And all you have to pretty much do is just put it right in front of the tiger salamander. I'm going to feed this big one right over here. And once he sees it coming, boom, they grab it and they just do the rest. Now these guys don't chew their food, they just swallow it whole. I will feed this one over here. And don't feed your tiger salamanders too much. That's pretty much all they need for one day. Tiger salamanders, if you feed them too much food, they can get a little bit obese. Some people feed their tiger salamanders pinky mice, which is fine every now and then, but pinky mice are filled with their mother's milk, and their mother's milk is very fattening. So, and thus, pinkies are very fattening, especially if you feed them every single day to your salamander, which is not an actively moving animal. They don't burn off a lot of calories very quickly. Feeding pinky mice to your tiger salamander all the time, you're going to get a big, fat, obese tiger salamander, and resulting in an unhealthy tiger salamander. I feed mine mostly cockroaches, crickets, every now and then some mealworms. And if you need to fatten up your tiger salamander, if you purchase a tiger salamander that's very thin, then you can pump it up with some small pinky mice. Of course, feed them frozen thawed pinky mice. Don't feed them live mice. And that will help put some meat on your tiger salamander's bones.